"It's simple," yawned Oliver. Now Oliver said that it is so simple that the king is coming to the forest for a picnic. Now buzz off. Buzz off means go away at once. So now here Oliver ordered the little hummingbird to go away at once and let him sleep. Then he closed his big brown eyes to sleep. The king, Hector had never seen the king. Hummingbird was very much excited to see the king. He spent the rest of the morning sipping nectar from the forest flowers. Now the food of the hummingbirds is nectar of the flowers. That's why they have long pointed beak, so that they can sip the nectar from the forest flowers. So how did the hummingbird spend the time waiting for the king? He sipped nectar from the forest flowers, and then he heard some sound. He fluttered through the trees until he came across the picnic. Now fluttered means flitted, that is to move lightly and quickly. The hummingbird fluttered through the trees. He moved through the trees, he flew through the trees to find out where was the king. And at last he was able to see the picnic. Wow, there was a king and the queen and even the little princess. So how many members were there of the royal family? There were three members of the royal family: king, queen and their little princess. Hector watched from the tree as the picnic continued. So now Hector was watching the picnic from a tree as the picnic was going on. And who other people were there? There were footmen. Footmen means servants, serving a huge array of treats. Array means arrangement of things. And tidbits. Tidbits means small tasty bits of food. So there was a wide variety of food, maybe in small quantity. Other servants flitted about making sure everything was perfect for the royal family. Now here you see the usage of the word flitted. You can notice that the word flitted was used in the beginning of this story for the hummingbird. That in the second line you can see he flitted over to where Oliver Owl was sleeping. And now here they are using the same word flitted for people also, for servants, that other servants flitted about making sure everything was perfect for the royal family. That the other servants, they were moving here and there. Why? To make sure that the royal family should not face any difficulty, everything should be perfect for them. Hector chuckled. Chuckled means laughed softly. So why Hector chuckled? The servants were just like hummingbirds, darting here and there. Here you see the servants were just like hummingbirds. This here it is actually a figure of speech used here, that is simile. Here servants are compared to the hummingbirds. That how are the servants? The servants are just like hummingbirds. In what way? Just as hummingbirds move here and there quickly, the same way servants were also moving here and there quickly. Darting means running or moving very quickly. Everybody was having a wonderful time until the queen looked up into the trees and screamed. Screamed means to make a loud, high sound. They were enjoying the picnic and everybody was having a wonderful time. But suddenly what happened? The queen looked up into the trees and then she screamed. "My baby," she cried, "my little girl." Everybody looked up. When the queen screamed, then everybody looked up. While they had been so busy picnicking, the princess had climbed high up into a big old oak tree and was now on a branch far above the ground. What happened? They all were busy in their fun, in their enjoyment, and that time the princess had climbed high up into a big old oak tree. What tree was it? It was an oak tree, and it was big. It was big, it was old. And the princess climbed up the tree, and now at that moment the princess was high above the ground on a branch of that big old oak tree. "Says my daughter," commanded the king, but just as his men ran towards the tree, the princess slipped. Now the king commanded his servants to save his daughter, but the princess slipped. But she did not fall down, she just slipped from that branch. And when she slipped, she grabbed the branch with her hands. Grabbing the branch, grabbing means to grasp suddenly, to hold suddenly. Grabbing the branch with her hands, she dangled helplessly up in the air. Dangled means to hung or swung freely. Thank God, the princess was able to grab the branch with her hands. Although she was dangling there helplessly up in the air. Why helplessly? Because no one was able to help her that time, and she was also helpless at that moment. She was hanging up in the air. She could not hold on very long and would surely fall because she was a little girl. So how long could she hold that branch? After some time she could fall down. She could have got hurt also. Suddenly the crowd gasped. Gasped means took a deep breath in surprise. There, way up in the tree, was a hummingbird, pulling the princess by the dress back onto the branch. What was the hummingbird doing there? Hummingbird, because hummingbird was there from the beginning. He was watching the picnic. So he pulled the princess, when he saw the princess in danger, he pulled the princess by the dress back onto the branch. But as you all know, hummingbird is himself a very small bird. So how long would it be possible for the hummingbird also to hold the princess? Hector pulled and pulled, and his wings hummed and hummed. But the princess was too heavy. Obviously, the princess was heavy, comparatively heavy for Hector to hold. And Hector was humming his wings continuously so that he could stay at that position, in the same position holding the princess. He could feel her slipping as her grip on the branch failed. Now Hector could feel that the princess was slipping more. The grip of the princess on the branch was getting loose. Then a voice sounded in his ear. "He who is not strong enough must be smart enough." This was actually a message for Hector. Then a voice, maybe the voice of the owl. Hector heard in his ear. He got the value. He got a message that he who is not strong enough must be smart enough. If we are not strong, then we should use our intelligence to face difficult situations.